Hey guys, it's Kaustubh here, and today we will be taking a look at the SKYDRAGON OS custom ROM, which is based upon Android Pie for the OnePlus 3D. And as per the drill, make sure you hit that red subscribe button down below and also turn the notifications on so that you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. With that being said, let's roll the intro and let's get the video started. So as always guys, firstly we will be taking a look at the about info of this ROM. Currently I have installed the SKYDRAGON OS, which is based upon Android 9 Pie, and I have installed it on the OnePlus 3T here. So I'll just quickly show you the about info of this ROM. In settings, about info, here as you guys can see, we are getting Android version 9. So this is an old ROM based upon older Android version, but it's not an issue. Then security patch level is August 1, 2019. So security patch is also an old security patch. Then talking about the kernel, this by default comes with a custom kernel, which is the Holy Dragon kernel, and that's the main speciality of this ROM guys. And here the build number has been given SKYDRAGON OnePlus 3. So that's about for the ROM info. Secondly, talking about is the display and the ROM customization that this ROM has. So if we go into the settings here in into display, then here we have all the basic options that we can expect from a ROM of this caliber. But something new that I found was screen stabilization. So basically this uses the gyroscope and stabilizes the screen, so even if you move the device, you can see the screen stabilizes itself. So that's a cool feature, but it will consume a lot of battery. Other than that, everything is present. Tap to wake is there, ambient display is there, always on display is also present. Dark theme is also present, but guys, mind me, this is not a system wide dark theme like Android 10. This is like just a device based, like it does for some apps, dark theme is selected automatically, but yeah, we have that option too. Then going into the ROM customizations, here we have a separate tab for ROM customizations with the dragon logo, which looks really cool. So if I go into here, we have all the customization option, that is styles, buttons, gestures, lock screen, miscellaneous, navigation bar, notification, quick settings, recent apps, status bar, weather and device features. Also another thing that I liked is in styles, so we get some pre-installed themes, that is SKYDRAGON themes, with some basic color combinations made so that your device can look good. Otherwise you can also set your own theme by selecting the accent color, the primary theme, the notification color as well, so that's a nice thing to have. So that's about for the customization options. Third thing talking about is the stock launcher, and guys, by default this comes with a launcher, but somehow it is crashing. So right now I have the Pixel launcher installed. Pixel launcher comes with gapps itself, so that's why Pixel launcher is the default launcher which I have right now here. It works pretty smooth. It is a Pixel launcher end of the day guys. You get some basic customization settings, that is notification dot at a glance, and each of them is pretty self-explanatory. It works pretty smooth. Talking about the next thing is about with the network guys. So if I will quickly go into network here, in network and internet, in mobile network I have the Airtel India SIM guys, and VOLTE is working absolutely fine. I have the VOLTE logo on the top, and currently my SIM card is inserted in SIM 1. So OnePlus 3D only supports VOLTE for only any one SIM. It cannot go dual VOLTE on both the SIM cards, so that's something to keep in mind. So VOLTE support is working absolutely fine with this ROM as well. Then the next thing guys is the AnTuTu benchmarks. Benchmark score is pretty like decent, I should say. It is not that high also, but yeah, the benchmark score is about 186,004. So that's the sort of benchmark score, and it is because benchmark scores guys again don't translate to real world performance. The scores doesn't matter a lot, but if you want it, you have the scores here. So talking about the PUBG performance guys, it is pretty good enough. It was averaging around 35 to 40 FPS. Like there were some lags in between the game, like I saw that frame drops were happening quite a lot. It might not get picked up on the camera, but the game is quite playable enough, and I have turned on the Spectrum gaming mode through the Spectrum app, which I will show you in the video later. So guys, as you saw in the PUBG gameplay that I had told you about the Spectrum app, so this ROM comes with the Spectrum app, and it is basically tunes your kernel. So this is the gaming mode which I'm talking about. We have certain modes, so mostly keep it on balance. If you want battery, you can keep it on battery. While gaming, you can put it on to gaming mode, and it really helps to play games quite easily. So that's a nice thing. And also this ROM by default comes with another app which is called as a Kernel Auditor basically, guys, just don't dive into this app, because if you know what you're doing, then only just go into this app. Talking about the camera performance of this ROM, guys, then surprisingly, this ROM just doesn't come with any AOSP camera pre-installed. So any which ways, you will have to install Gcam Mod here, and Gcam Mod 7.3 works absolutely fine. I will not dive into the details as always, guys. I have already made a video about the Gcam Mod. You can check it out right here. So guys, finally concluding the video, and also I will be talking about the battery life. So battery life is pretty stellar. Like, it is like too good, I should say, with this ROM especially. So in the battery menu here, we get all the traditional options, that is a battery saver, then battery manager is adaptive battery, then this option which you see here, which is aggressive battery saver, this is a life saver option, guys. The SOT I was getting was really great. I was getting around some days 6 hours of SOT, as you can see in the screenshots, and on an average I would say I was getting around 4.5 hours of SOT with heavy use, I should say. And it also, this is quite possible because of this Spectrum kernel app, which comes basic with the Holy Dragon kernel which this ROM has. And I can proudly say, guys, that this ROM is much better than the CR DROID version 5.10. so I have been recommending that CR DROID ROM for quite a while, but now I guess I have found a new competitor to that ROM, and this is equally good. Like, equally also not, I should say, it is much better than CR DROID version 5.10. so that was also a Pi based ROM, and this one is also a Pi based ROM. And if you are wondering what is CR DROID version 5.10, I have made a video right here, you can check it out too. So finally, guys, concluding the video, what I would say is that I would highly recommend you guys to try out this ROM. This is the SKYDRAGON OS based upon Android 9 Pi, and just don't go for CR DROID anymore. Just go for this ROM. This is a good ROM with good performance, with good battery backup as well. And if you want something which is based upon Android 10, which is also quite stable, then you can go for Evolution X 4.4, which is also a good ROM, and I've also made a video about it right here. So that's what I think about this ROM. So that's about it, guys. I hope you guys like this video, and if you like it, then please do hit the like button down below, and also do get subscribed to my channel for more awesome content. This is your boy Kaustubia from T2E signing off. You guys have a great day.